I told you that 57% of you isn't even human? Sounds like a plot twist, right? But it's true. Most of what makes you, you, isn't actually you. A few months ago, I was fascinated by this fact. So naturally, I decided to dig deeper. And the results? They were mind-boggling. It turns out we're home to trillions of tiny microorganisms. Bacteria, viruses, fungi, a whole invisible universe living inside of us. We used to think that the brain called the shots, but science is revealing a shocking truth. These microbes may be shaping the way we think, feel, and even act. The human microbiome is the vast collection of tiny microorganisms living in and on our bodies, especially inside our guts. Think of it as a microscopic metropolis, bustling, complex, yet surprisingly influential. In fact, your microbes outnumber your human cells by about 1.3 to 1. But they're not just loitering around. These microbes produce several vitamins essential to the human function, such as vitamin K, which helps with blood clotting and the healing of wounds. Vitamin B2 keeps your skin and nervous system healthy. Vitamin B6 supports energy storage and the creation of hemoglobin, the stuff that carries oxygen in your blood. And vitamin B12 helps with the creation of red blood cells and the reparation of DNA. But their influence doesn't stop at physical health. Here's where it gets really interesting. There's something called the gut-brain axis, a two-way communication system between your gut and your brain. Yes, your gut is literally talking to your brain. Microbes in your gut influence the production of several key hormones, such as serotonin, the feel-good chemical that affects mood and sleep, dopamine, involved in motivation and reward, and the primary stress hormone, cortisol. So, if you're feeling down or struggling to sleep, the culprit might not be your thoughts. It may be your gut. Okay, so we've got this powerful microbial community living inside of us. How do we keep it happy? The simple answer? Food, but not just any food. Let's go through a few examples of what's best for your gut. Firstly, prebiotics. The microbiome's fertilizer, found in fruits, vegetables, whole grains, and legumes. Some of the best? Garlic, onions, and asparagus. Yes, your gut loves garlic breath. Next, probiotics. The friendly reinforcements. These are live bacteria we can eat, found in fermented foods, such as yogurt, any type will do, miso, and my personal favorite, kimchi. In addition, we also have antioxidants. These support a healthy gut lining while balancing the good bacteria. Great examples include dark chocolate, you can thank me later, basil, plums, and pomegranates. Okay, so we've looked at what's optimum for our gut, what will help it grow and thrive. Now let's look at the not-so-gut-friendly choices. Sugar and artificial sweeteners. Too much of this can feed the bad bacteria, possibly leading to the inflammation or damage of the gut lining. Ultra-processed foods. These starve the bacteria of fiber, necessary to create short-chain fatty acids, essential in keeping your gut strong. And unfortunately for some, our little friends are obsessive teetotalers. They won't tolerate alcohol in the slightest. And lastly, unnecessary antibiotics. These drugs kill bacteria indiscriminately, good and bad. So only take them when truly needed. Look, I'm not telling you to give up fast food forever. I mean, I myself love a cheeky McDonald's. But it's all about balance. Having a diet rich in variety, fiber, and fermented foods can boost your mood, rebuild your gut, and even improve your sleep. Small changes in your lifestyle can lead to huge improvements in your health, both mental and physical. Because here's the truth. You're not alone. You're a walking ecosystem. Take care of your gut, and it might just take care of you. Thank you.